Hey, welcome back. This is episode 2 of Let's Play Dark Souls, Scholar of the First Sin on the PlayStation 3. All right. Now, this is Kalane, right? Let's look at her. She's so, I want to say pretty. You should see her on a better day, right? She's a little dead right now, has no pupils, but she's breathing. You know, she's got that breathing animation, so clearly something's going on inside of there. I'm in some raggedy clothing, but I like my hairstyle. My hair didn't seem to get, you know, dead and straw-like and scraggly. I wonder what's up with that. Anyway, that doesn't really matter. So we just got to this area, but there's some items that I want to pick up, actually. And it's like, oh, well, man, you know, geez. Should you just be, like, grabbing items and knowing where they are? Well, no, probably not, right? But I've played this game before, and really, I'm excited to get to some of the new content. And while I'm getting to the new content, though, I want to kind of go ahead and give you a chance to see the old content. Now, I can almost never remember. Yeah, okay, it's right here. All right, so here's your first, like, super-duper secret. Okay, woo, we're gonna fall down. And be absolutely... Oh, no, okay, yeah. For a second, I was like, wait a second, did I get that wrong? No. This guy got it wrong. He fell all the way down. So, a cleric's sacred chime and a morning star. Already picking up some cool items, some loot. But what I'm really in it for is this guy right here. These are binoculars, okay? Now, one of the cool things about the binoculars and the fact that I'm a mage means that I can go ahead and I can target people from afar in a very accurate way. So normally you've got your lock-on, but your lock-on's limited to maybe about, like, what, like, 6-7 lengths of your character away? I don't know how I'd measure that. And is that feet? Is that 2 feet? I don't know. And now, this place, Majula, is full of items and secrets, so it's worth your time to go ahead and grab what you can. There's tons of soul items, and there's really a great way to just kick your character off. If you want to go ahead and you want to get someone who's going to be prepared for this journey, okay? And it's, I don't want to say this is like a shortcut into it, because it's not really a shortcut. And even though I bought this like day one, I did not take the time to ever activate my code to get like the extra items. I wanted that sort of pure Dark Souls experience, and I was afraid that if I actually used the DLC items, I'd get like reliant on having, you know, better equipment, right? I'd start off with a shield and, you know, a selection of various items. And I didn't want to do that to myself. I didn't want to handicap myself by actually giving myself an unfair advantage. And I know that sounds silly, right? Like, man, who says that? Who does that? You can't be for real, are you? I'm totally for real. Now, there are some enemies in that corner, and for the most part, Majula is a nice, quiet, safe little town. It's got that sleepy music. And, of course, you know, not a lot of areas in this game actually have music, right? It's pretty much reserved for bosses and Majula. And that's about it. I don't even think there's any exceptions. If any of the people watching can remember any exceptions, please let me know, because I'm drawing a blank. I realize I haven't continued on with the story. Basically, I'm just putting myself in a good position. That way, you get to watch me die a little bit less. In fact, I'd like to have a video to death ratio that is less than 1-to-1. Okay, so I'm on video 2, I've had 1 death, right? So that's a 2-to-1 ratio. So for my first video, unfortunately, I already failed that ratio. So I'll have to admit it and say, oh man, you know, geez, I should have done better. I should have done a lot better, but that's okay. All right, we just picked up a Crimson Parma, which is really awesome. Like, you know, Crimson Parma get, right? You know, you revived. I love some of the dialogue in this series. And these might sound like random phrases. They mean something, though, to Souls fans. And I'll tell you, you know, no game, I think, ever taught me genuine discipline more than Dark Souls 2. And it's like, well, you know, wait, why are you going to be playing a video game to learn discipline? Well, I'll tell you what. It teaches you patience. It teaches you all these ways to kind of use your environment, to use what you have and kind of work with it. So, you know, we got a merchant in here. We'll talk to him in a bit. He's a nice guy. He's got some dialogue that I actually care about, but we're going to go up here first. Yeah, and he's a pretty good guy. We're gonna get this treasure chest. And we got a Titanite shard. Now, Titanite shards are items that allow you basically to upgrade your equipment. Oh man, I thought I could do that. Sometimes I'm used to a little bit more of a traditional jump button in games. It's fine that this game doesn't have it. It doesn't really fit the gameplay style for it to have one. But at times, it could be maybe a little helpful. I know that I certainly would, like, appreciate having a jump button. But even though I don't, that's okay. Alright, yep, that's a character there, that cat. Well, we're going to want to talk to her in a little bit. But I think at this point, am I satisfied with what I have? Maybe. I think that there's a guy around the ledge here that I can, you know, get stuff from. Yeah, like right over here. All right, great. Soul of a nameless soldier. Now, so here's the thing. So you die, you lose your souls. Okay, pretty straightforward. But here's something else to consider. When you die, you keep your items. Okay, so I tend to actually use a lot of my runs to, instead of caring about the souls, because souls are replaceable for the most part. Now, enemies do stop spawning, I think, after being killed between 10 and 15 times, unless they've changed it. But as far as I know, they eventually stop respawning. But, you know, items are kind of forever. You know, it's like diamonds. Diamonds are forever. You know, well, except for consumables, then obviously you use them. So we can talk to this, well, we could talk to this guy. But let's go ahead and let's at least start the story off a little bit. So we're going to talk to her. This is the Maiden in Black. I mean, the Crimson Herald.
Are you the next monarch?
Perhaps.
Or merely a pawn of fate?
Probably that too.
Bearer of the curse. I will remain by your side till this frail hope shatters. Take this with you. May it ease your journey.
All right, we got an Estus Flask. And of course, those of you who played the original Dark Souls and maybe never played this, Estus Flask, basically, they're like a healing item. It's a consumable and it's not a consumable. So it can be powered up to kind of give you more health, and it can be powered up to give you more drinks. So I guess it's got some kind of hammer space inside of it where...
Bearer of the curse, seek misery. For misery will lead you to greater strength.
Sorry, this is the only time she actually says this.
You will never meet the king with a soul so frail and pallid.
Alright, yeah. Sorry, so there's this joke that kind of goes online, and it actually stems from... It stems from the way that you interact with this lady here, the Crimson Herald. We're going to take a look at her face. You know, most of the time you don't get a chance to see what these characters look like, right? It does this, it's not as bad as Nier, but it does this depth of field, pixel blur, and I wish I could sort of deactivate it. Unfortunately, this is a PlayStation 3 version, and so no mods. That's okay. I do like this version, though.
Seek those whose names are unutterable. The four endowed with immense souls. Their souls will serve as beacons. Once you have found them, return here to me, so that hope will not fade away. Is that a shard you found? Here, let me see it, so that I may help you.
It is, in fact, a shard. I mean, shard.
However faint it might be.
Nice. All right, so what we've done, that shard that I got up, I know it's terrible, but I'm already going to give the Estus Flask shard here. And there used to be an animation when this happened, and it's gone now. I haven't seen it since, like, the original version, and I feel like they just never addressed it to make it happen. So normally, this is a part where we'd level up, but we don't have a lot of souls. But you know what we did? We looked at items, and we found a bunch of items. So I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to eat some souls. That sounds delicious. We're nutritious. Tastes just like chicken. So I already know how I want to build my character. And we're going to go ahead, and we're going to use all two souls here. And this should actually make this playthrough a little bearable and kind of make it good.
Bearer of the curse. Seek souls. Larger, more powerful souls. Seek the king. That is the only way. Lest this land swallow you whole, as it has so many others.
That's true. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to level up. Sweet. Yeah, I'm going to get on my knee and foot here. Okay, so cool. What are stats? What do stats do? Well, you can press select and get the help. But yeah, basically, vigor is your health. Endurance, it dictates how many hit points you have, how much your stamina is, and your poise. Poise is important. Poise kind of keeps you on your toes, literally. Prevents you from being kind of knocked over or staggered. Staggered is really the word that I'm looking for. Vitality. Vitality is your equipment load, so like how much you can carry. Yeah, apparently it's your poison resistance. I actually didn't remember that. And it's your hit points. But really, vigor has the most influence over hit points. We have attunement. Attunement actually enables you to have slots. And what do slots do? Slots enable you to equip spells. And what am I? I'm a sorcerer. I'm going to want to invest in that. Probably from early on. And it also increases your cast speed. So for instance, I can knock it up one to do that. And so that's cool, right? And one level of investment, I now have two slots, and I've slightly increased my cast speed. I am not a very strong character, right? My strength is 3. I almost wish I could cash that in and sell like the remaining 2 points, but I can't. So that's okay. Now, adaptability used to be a useless stat. In this one, though, it's also tied to poise and agility. And of course, your resistances. It does increase your hit points slightly. I guess apparently it does supposedly tie into poison, but I don't remember that being a big deal. Intelligence. That's my biggest stat here. And intelligence does also, I think, yeah, does also have a have an effect on your casting speed. That's okay though. So we're just able to pump 2 points in, but we're gonna go from level 11 to level 13, right at the beginning of the game. Yeah, you know, flick your fingers and you know, boom, we've leveled up. All right, I could talk to her, but I'm not worried about it. So what did she say? She said to seek the souls of large souls. And, you know, that was terrible, right? That was like, what? Seek the souls of large souls? That's horrible. What does that even mean? Well, that means that I misspoke. But basically, we're given kind of a hint, and then we're just thrown off into the game, right? Like, it's almost as bad as Morrowind. In fact, it's even worse. Now, I love Morrowind. Morrowind's one of my favorite games. But what I mean is that Morrowind does not have any pretense about holding your hand. It does not tell you where to go. Well, yeah, actually, I'm a liar. It totally tells you where to go in, like, an abstract way. And then it just leaves you to your own devices. This game does something similar, but even worse, it actually does not even have, like, a quest log or anything. So you have to keep track of what you're doing or what you've done. So we're going to talk to this guy.
You're undead, aren't you?
Hey, what gave you the first clue? Was it my face? Tell me it was
you
my face.
You have that distinct scent. The smell of irreversible fate.
Hey, I took a shower, buddy.
This is Majula. It is a kind of settlement. A place where life is almost normal. And in Drang Lake these days, there are very few places like that.
Now, I'll be honest with you, this guy, he's got maybe about 6 sets of dialogue before
he
does something useful.
Soldan. And like you, I lost everything. And now I'm here. You probably heard that it was possible to break the curse here. Well, that's not true at all. There's nothing here for you, me, or anybody.
Then why do you all live here? I mean, clearly there's something here. You can't just exaggerate
much
like
about
that.
Souls. Even I'm not certain, but I'm told that the soul is the essence of life itself. Anything living, sentient or no, supposedly has one. What we call the curse is traceable to the soul. Do you see what that means? To be alive, to walk this earth.
I could just watch that sunset
the real
for a while.
Curse, right there.
I don't even think it's anything more than a moving texture, because as I'm looking at those waves, they don't look dynamic. I'm watching the same series, shape of wave, kind of just move across. Now, I've done some cheap trickery like that before in 3D modeling, where I've just got a a parallax scrolling texture, and it's, you know, displacement map, a spectral map, and it's just reflecting light.
Sooner or later, come up against them.
And there's nothing wrong with that, actually. It's a really cheap way to achieve a really cool effect, right? That's why bump mapping is so amazing, because you're basically pretending to have geometry when you really don't have it.
If that frightens you, then you ought to just give up right now, like I have.
Right? Okay, so he's gonna laugh.
Do you ever cry out for help?
All the time. Every night, buddy.
The journey of an undead is long and treacherous.
Especially when I listen to you.
You'll face invaders from other worlds at every turn.
So, I want to get a chance to grab our first trophy here.
If you need help, why not proclaim faith in the Blue Sentinels?
Yeah, sure, why not? I'll do that. I'd love to do
when
some jolly cooperation.
Danger, the Blue Sentinels will come to your aid. Protection is yours, if you wish. You need only accept their kind embrace.
Okay, so what's the catch? Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to join the Way of the Blue Covenant. Great. We'll hear a little ding in a second. There we go. Covenant of the Meek. It's fine. We're just trying to go ahead and grab all of the covenants. I don't know that I want to do this as a perfect playthrough. Those are never fun. And I'll be honest, if you look at my normal profile, which I'm not going to reveal, I don't actually have a perfect playthrough of this game. I was still in the process of doing stuff. And then life happened, and I didn't really have time for video games. And now, ironically, I'm actually building my life around generating value with video games. So, from that perspective, actually, it's kind of fantastically ironic. Let's go ahead and let's talk to this guy.
Hello there. Welcome to my shop. I'm Morlin, and I sell armor. Oh, sorry, please do have a look at my wares. I could really use the business, if you'd be so kind.
Oh no, you're selling wares. as a reference to software wares. Okay, so yeah, all these things are really expensive. That's okay.
Well, I
do hope to see you again too someday. Okay, so we have a shield, and now that I think about it, I don't actually have the stats to even equip a shield. Right, I need at least 6 strength. So that'll be one of our first goals, because without that strength, I'm going to have a hard time in the early game. I like to block. I can dodge, and I will dodge as necessary. But not having a shield doesn't necessarily set me up for, like, the greatest of success. No, I'm not too worried about it. So we're going to go ahead and head to the first area. We got our Estus Flask. We should go ahead and equip that. All right, so we actually have 2 uses of the Estus Flask. And what else do I want? No. Homeward Bone, Bone of Order. Homeward Bone would be nice to have in my inventory. Now, what that does is that actually basically allows me to... I want to keep my equip weight down. So you'll notice it started to turn red. No, that's fine. Ooh, no, it's not. If you're above 25%, it actually does affect your roll speed. So right here, though, that doesn't. So that's kosher. We can totally do that. All right, we're going to pick up that item. It's a rusted coin. We may have actually picked up one of those already. I can't remember. What do rusted coins do? Well, I actually don't remember. That's okay. That's all right. So we're going to go, whoa. We're going to go ahead and we're going to pull the switch. I feel like there's some people who are going to be impressed like with how I play, and then there's going to be like really hardcore gamers who are like, oh man, you don't giant daddy very well, or, you don't, what's the word, a Havel Mage. You need to be a Havel Mage. Well, I'm going to be whoever I want to be, right? I am not a Havel Mage. I am not anything. I am, in fact, just who my character is, as dictated by my preferences. We're going to go down here. We're going to pick this up. This is super useful to get. Now, I can also make that jump there, but, given the sort of tumultuous nature of that jump that I made earlier, I'm going to do it. All right, so that's fine. Let me go ahead and get myself lined up, and there we go! Leap of faith here, right? Homeward Bone and Lost Soul. Or Soul of the Lost something or other. Lost Undead, maybe? Okay. Cool. No need to take unnecessary risks. There's some enemies patrolling around here. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to target the first one that we see. Oh, and you know, I need to think about that. I should go ahead and I should equip those binoculars. Because they're going to help me out. I'll basically get to be like a magic sniper kind of early on in the game. I hope this is actually fun, like, to watch as, you know, as I do know a pretty darn high amount of things about this game. I was obsessed with it. Like, I probably put, an embarrassingly high number of hours into it. So I'm really hoping that the DLC will be a challenge. And I think my character, my friend, his character was like a knight or something. Kind of a, not a generic knight, but just a knight. You know what? No. Have some staff. Oh, man, the AI is just terrible. Well, all right, no. Actually, that's not necessarily strictly speaking true. And so we're going to go over here. We're going to go to our first bonfire that's actually somewhere that's, like, somewhat dangerous. Interesting thing. Resting in a bonfire will actually make it to where enemies respawn. What? Why would you do that? Well, you also get all your health and magics and, more importantly, your castings of magic back. So I don't need to worry about him anymore. I can just go ahead and I can kind of pick him off at a distance. Same thing with this guy. Now, there is a sniper that I need to be careful about. Yep, I see. I just took some damage. And I'll tell you, one of the most useful items actually in this game, and why I think that this is nowhere near as difficult as people make it sound, is the life gem. Now, life gems are amazing, okay? So, in the first game in Demon's Souls, you had grass, and for the most of the early game, grass was like, it was a rare thing to have for healing. Not so in this game. Our healing items, see, that was a stack. That's why you want to have poise. Right there, because that is actually a very crippling thing to have happen. So I was getting hit constantly like I've been. It makes me look like an amateur. Like, man, what are you doing? You're supposed to be good. I'm gonna stop self-referencing here. Because it's kind of pointless. All right, you look at this guy. He's a little dead. Oh, come on, really? I knew he was there. There we go. Thanks for doing the thing where you die. I appreciate it. We're gonna pick up an item. Soul of the Lost Undead. So by the time we get to our next checkpoint, which isn't too far off, although it is definitely quite a bit of danger away, and that's a good metric to kind of consider, right? Is not necessarily is it worth it, but how dangerous is it for me to go from this place to this place? I can shimmy up the ladder. Okay. So there should be three of these, you know, Don Quixote looking guys. With their little Spaniard helmets. No! Okay. I am not trying to run away. I am just trying to emphasize the fact that I am soft, squishy, and very easy to kill. There we go. Now the lock-on, honestly, amazing feature. There we go, they're both dead. That's what I want to do, but yeah, there's someone who's gonna snipe me. And you know, don't be too worried about this guy. He won't mess with you unless you mess with him, right? He is just kind of a little dejected, a little sad. In fact, he is a knight of something. Oh gosh, what are they? They're the knights of, you know, knights of knee, right? And he doesn't really go knee. But what we do go is we go and we find the hidden path. Actually, that's like awesome. That's right here. And we shimmy. I got 19 life gems. I don't need life gems like that, but that's okay. What we're gonna do is we're gonna do this anyway, because one of the things that you can do is you can kind of like pre-heal, okay? So I get hit, my life gem's still going off, and my health goes up. That's a great way to play. It's an excellent strategy, especially if you're gonna do something risky, like, you know, jumping down something. And presuming your fall damage doesn't actually kill you, your life gem is kind of working to buff up your health. So, all right, now our sniper dude guy is up here, and there are also some cool items up here. Okay. My name is Gato, I've got metal joints. Beat me up and earn 15 silver points. Alright, so. We can do this here. Short sword and soul of a lost undead. We totally need that. And we're gonna make another jump. So now we got rid of our sniper. Now here's the thing. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna take out that soldier that... Oh, it's alone. A-L-O-N-N-E. So he is so alone here. He's forever alone. Ha ha ha. Is that still a thing? I don't know. I don't even keep up with modern memes. But, like, that was a thing at one point. That, you know, people would, like, reference. And, I don't know. Is that the same thing that my crowd probably references? Probably. If not, this is just super awkward and weird. We're going to go ahead and we're going to turn this on. And we're going to shoot him for all we've got. Okay? And now he's actually not that hard, but he is going to run at us soon. And he's going to hurt like hell. So, and in this game, normal enemies can absolutely kill the heck out of you. Although he's really not a normal enemy. I mean, he's not like a mini boss either. He's kind of in this interesting nexus between the two. I like how he tried to sneak up on me. I actually felt that. I felt that like little jitter in my heart as he came up. All right, yeah, we got to hide. Oh, hide, not alone, hide. Oops. Whatever, hide knights, lone knights. Hidey, 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 ho. We're going to go... I thought I heard some footsteps. Okay. We're going to go through the mist. Enter in through here. I'm just looking at the time. The time. Not the time of day that it is, but rather how long I've actually been recording. Because I need to evaluate how long this video needs to be. Now, really, I think I'm going to stop at the next bonfire, which is not very far. Although it does feel a little bit farther than typical. Hey, look at him. He thinks he's smart, right? What's he going to do? He's gonna come right here. Oh man, he's gonna try and jump stab me or oh, I forgot about him though. See, look at that. I'm opening myself up to a lot of junk. Now, what's nice about this dagger too, you'll notice that I'm able to get hits in typically before they can. Oh yeah, hold on. We're gonna equipment and we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna equip the binoculars. Where'd they go? I actually don't see them. Oh, you know what? That's because they're not that kind of equipment. They're this kind of equipment. So, what are we going to do? I'm going to snipe him with the binoculars. It's going to be very cool. Yep. Nope. We don't need to play that. Homie, don't play that. It's all good. Okay, now, I think I got rid of everybody in here. Just fine. And, you know, it's funny. As good as I am, I've seen people who are just amazing at this game. Who just, you know, I think I know about the game. I don't know jack squat about the game. And I'll tell you, the most entertaining anything I ever had with a Souls series game was Ghost Robo and his first attempt at playing through the original Dark Souls. Because, you know, he did not play it perfectly. And it showed, and it was really awesome, though, because he kept with it for a while. He did get frustrated for a bit, because, you know, for a long time, actually, I was really excited about his playthrough. Like, I would watch it, and I'd watch it with my girlfriend. And, you know, it was a phenomenal experience. He's got such a positive attitude, and actually, he's one of my influences here. It was, like, the first YouTuber I think I subscribed to from intplusone channel. All right, we're going back. Now, you'll notice, what am I doing? I'm consuming a lot of healing items. But I don't think I'm doing so in a reckless way. In fact, I almost think I've kind of under-provisioned my usage. Would you stop? Okay. Come on. See, I'm out of all my magic casting, so anything I do, it has to actually be physical right now. Which, you know, what is my specialty? Well, it's not physical attacks, I can tell you that much. Nope. My specialty is looking pretty and being dead. And also not getting killed by this guy as he surprises me while I get this item. Now, there's a lot of ways that we can go. The first area is actually really open. Maybe a little more than typical, too, now that I think about it, because some of the later areas are a tiny bit linear. You know, without mentioning any names, right? There's certain offenders who are worse than others. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to open this door. We're not necessarily going to go in just yet. Whoop. Ha! Look at that. I tried to preemptively do it. Oh, you can't do that with the big doors. It sees that and it's like, nope, no, you gotta open that door fair and square. All right, buddy, I'll open the door fair and square. Let me get my item. And look, we got a guy with a big, giant spear, and you know he's taking a lot of hits to take down. Luckily, he can swing a lot slower than I can. That's one thing, actually, to think about in this game, too. So, like, I know it sounds silly, but I learned this trick, actually, a little bit from a friend who played fighting games. And so, you know, games actually have, like, frame data, right? I mean, these videos have frames. And so, to a certain degree, I mean, you know, maybe not in like a literally perfect way, but you can kind of detect how many frames that something is, and you know, by the eye, right? So like normal broadcast TV, what is that? That's 29.7 frames per second, and you know, 60 frames a second typically is 59.94 frames a second. Now, it gets a little complicated because this game technically runs at 30 frames a second. These videos are encoded at 30 frames a second, despite the fact that they're actually recorded at 59.94 frames a second. Actually, unfortunately, 1080i. And you're never going to notice because I scale it down anyway, because I don't give a care. I don't need that full resolution. Because for me, it's part of the experience is the entertainment, not necessarily the way that it looks. So I'm sorry if you're like a graphics person and you're like, man, really? That's terrible. You should totally encode it much higher. Well, my source isn't very high, though. The PlayStation 3, unfortunately, has some really crummy HDMI, HDCP 1.4 garbage that goes on that really prevents you from doing a lot of things that you want to do. So what do I want to do? I want to upgrade my strength. Okay. Not because I'm a physical character, but because I want to make sure that I can actually have a shield. Next, I want to go ahead and I want to increase my faith. And that concludes our leveling up session here. So we've jumped from level 11 to level 17, and I'm really excited about that. We're gonna leave for a second, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and consume some souls. So let's go ahead and do that. We got two here. Oh, we got three actually. So let's go ahead and use all three. Soul of a Lost Undead. That should give us the ability to do one more level up, which is great. Bearer of the Curse. Bearer, seek lest. Okay, level up. And what do we want to do? Well, let's see here. I would like to increase my intelligence, or no. Does anything actually here, if I get my, you know, a clip load might actually be important to do. Endurance. Well, all right, so I hate to dump points into vigor, because I usually, no, you know what? I'm not going to dump any points into vigor. Like, the beginning of the game is way too easy, so dexterity, HP, poison, no. But see, I'm not really gonna build a dex character. I'm gonna build an int character. So we're gonna increase that magic bonus. For sure. Because that dictates directly how much damage we can do. Okay, cool. Now, are we gonna continue to go the traditional path? Yeah, probably. There are certainly some items I wanna go ahead and get. But you know what? I'm going to go ahead and end this episode right here because we're in Majula. It's a nice, safe place, very scenic. So what I want you to do? What do I want you to do? I hope you've enjoyed this, right? I'm trying to bring a lot of energy, a lot of passion, a lot of excitement to my videos. And this is genuine. This is not some fakery or anything like that. This is literally living the dream. This is kind of doing the what you love. And I'm really hoping to turn this into something real. I have a lot of goals that I want to meet in real life. And I want to do a lot of good, actually. And I'll talk a little bit more about that. And eventually I'm going to stop talking about doing it. And I'm going to actually talk about doing it. But for now, I want you to subscribe. I want you to check out some of my other videos, right? I got some amazing playthroughs in progress. Enchanted Arms, Nier, both from Software Games. Playing through Little Big Planet 2, co-op with a buddy. Earth Defense Force 2025. And, you know, I'm playing through so many different games that I actually have forgotten. I haven't forgotten what I'm doing. I always look through my list and I can just pick one up and do an episode here and there. But I'm trying to pump out a ton of content, right? I just launched this on the 26th. The 26th of August, officially. You know, this channel was around, I think, since the 13th, whatever. Trying to build a lot of momentum, trying to build a lot of growth. It's not about being famous. It's actually about getting out there and making a difference. And there's a lot more to this channel than just let's play videos. But this is what's going to draw people in. And in a way, it's kind of a way for me to relax and do something constructive. So that's awesome. I don't get a chance to play many video games. I'm crazy, crazy busy. I do a lot of things in real life. But go ahead and subscribe. Really enjoyed it. Again, this is intplusone channel. And I hope you check me out for episode 3 of Let's Play Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. And this is the A side where I had a friend do the B side. So, you know what? Permalengi, I'll see you next time.